The measurement of music, bar, one bar, two bar, three bars. Now, I'm going to tell you a secret that most of the musicians doesn't tell you. You guys listen to music every day, right? But do you know there is something which is actually happening behind this music? And that's how you actually count the bars. Literally, you don't need to count the bars. It's just listening to it, you can understand, okay, this is this much bar. Faster the song moves, the longer, the more bars you cover. So if I play, this is like a genre of house music, a style of music which is house. Now let me play something. So I'm gonna count. So this music, I believe in every 8 bars or 16 bars there will be some changes coming in. Alright? Now 1 bar is 4 beats. Alright guys, 1 bar is 4 beats. So let's start counting. You gonna count with me? Okay, I'm gonna lift one finger every 4 beats. That's 1 bar. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's 8. Now you see, after 8, something is coming in the vocals. There's a rising up vocal which is coming in. I've stopped counting, but I know after some time there'll be some effects which is coming in, telling me that it's almost 16 bars. See that? Right? Let me take another track now. Let's see what happens in that. Okay? 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And 1, 2, 3, 4. You heard that? So every 8 bars there will be some changes in this song. So let me start from the 8th bar now, where you start singing the vocals, okay? Right? If you can do more than that, you're a superhuman. Trust me. Okay? So, if I play any hip-hop track, or anything R&B, or maybe slower track, any genre from any part of the world, cultural-wise, anything. So 4 bars, it will come up to, you can say, you know, slower track. You can understand that. Now, I don't know if you have heard the new track, Shape of You. Okay? Ed Sheeran, yeah. Now, I have always a problem teaching my students about progressions. Every music has got progression. Without the progression, you cannot go forward. You get me? So, after 8 bars, as this song, which is house music, is telling us about the progression, like when to, what to start. Like, for example, imagine yourself in a band. You're watching me, and there are band people. Like, I have a drummer, I have a guitarist, I have a keyboard player, right? Now, the drummer starts first giving the kick. Now drum is not an instrument, right? The drummer goes on the. Now the keyboard player doesn't know when to start. Unless the drummer gives a signal to him saying that, okay, this is the time, I've completed the 4 bar or the 8 bar, right? If the song is faster, 8 bars, 16 bars, slower, 4 bars. So what does the drummer do? At the end of the 4th bar, he starts doing some harakat. You know, which is like, or else he just removes the kick and starts. Okay, then the keyboard player will go, oh, I have to start now. Okay, and after the keyboard player starts with the drummer, now the singer knows that I have to start after these progressions. So every song has got a progression. Now listen to this. Again, I'm changing this song, and let's see where the progression comes in. Or something added up. Fuego. Okay? Now let's see. Now you heard that there was an effect which came in before the end of the bar. Listen to it once more. That was a step. Okay? Now the water is getting in, the stair is getting in. Every 8 bars, this song has got a progression telling the synthesizer or the synth player or any instrumentalist, even in today's electronic music production also, has the same thing. That's what a producer does in his studio. You know, so he thinks about the bar progression, how to bring in the instrument or take out the instrument. But if we listen without the progression, what happens is our brain doesn't accept it. Trust me. Okay? It doesn't accept it. We are programmed like that maybe, I don't know. Maybe you have to ask the scientists, but that's how I listen to music, or maybe you all listen to music, right? Okay, now let's come up to some calculations here. Now, we have specific terminologies on based on DJ. We all follow a pattern. As I told you, the first thing is rhythm. So that's why when you see DJs, they're actually following a rhythm, not the beat. A beat also, the beat also sits on the rhythm. So the rhythm is constant. If I play any slow song, for example, let me tell you. Okay, let me play something in hip hop. So what's the rhythm on this? Can you get the rhythm? Come on, it's like. And you can't talk to rhythm. Trust me, that's it. Rhythm doesn't change. Keep staying. Just goes like that. You know? So, same thing with any fast music. Now, what's the rhythm on this? Anybody? Come on, clap your hands. Clap on the rhythm. Yeah, keep on. That's it, simple, right? It's very simple. But what do we do is basically we follow the beats. That's what the musicians don't tell you because they don't want you to compete with them and, you know, be on top. But you got it in you, you know, you guys have got it in you to be a DJ or a musician. There's no age limit for this. As I told you, I'm 43, I'm still DJ. I started 43 years ago, started as a drummer, yeah? And I started as a DJ also after that. So I'm teaching today, I'm producing today music. I didn't know anything about music. I don't know how to play keyboard, trust me. I don't know how to play keyboard, I don't know how to play guitar, nothing. But I have my own original compositions. Just listening to it, understanding the basics of music. Now let me tell you one more thing. Very interesting story. Okay? In DJing, there's something called harmonic mixing. Most of the people don't tell you that. Now what is harmonic mixing? There are 7 notes. Yeah? Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti. Yeah? Now every song is built upon one root note. Okay, we find out the scale of that root note and we build that song on top of that root note. So that root note has got families like do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do, re, mi, and goes on a different octave, like higher or lower. And on top of it, when we play harmonically, it sounds good. That's why producers today who became DJs are well known. Why? Because they can play the music harmonically. They don't have to play by BPM wise. For example, Tiesto or Armin van Buuren, all these guys have been producers before, became a DJ later. But the DJs who are just technically skilled, you know what I'm saying? And they don't know anything about music, they actually end up somewhere else. They can play DJ, their skill set is good, everything is fine, but to know music first will always help you to be a better DJ. Please understand that. If you want to be a good DJ, trust me, learn a little bit about scales and chords. Now, what are thoughts? What are skills? It's a bit technical, but nothing is impossible. You can learn. Chords is just two, three notes together. For example, do, re, and mi. Yeah? These three notes you play together. It's a chord. Nothing else. And from chords, you can make melodies, a lot of other things. We have tutorials online. You can go and check it out on, you know, Logic Beats, or you can check DJ Neo, just type DJ Neo Dubai. You'll find a lot of tutorials from my site, which are posted for free. Anybody can watch it, yeah? Now, do you have any questions about DJ? Why are you guys here? I'm actually, you know, I want to know why you guys are here. I can see your faces, sir. You're like, oh my God. But you love DJ? I mean, have you?
Interested.
You're interested.
I have nothing to do with
it. You got it. So what is your profession, though? Wow, that's great, that's great. And how about you, sir? You came in first, but I want to ask you as well. Like, why DJ? You're intrigued, see? With these things?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, see? I told you. How about you guys? You love music. Yeah, see? Okay, and if you can play music, what's better than that, right? How about you, sir? Yeah? That's good. Okay, let me tell you what my real profession is. Okay? I'm a psychologist, a PhD psychologist. Can you believe that? But I left that, and today, 15 years I've been just DJing and making music and teaching. And I love this because I love my job. I don't feel that I'm going 12 hours or 24 hours, you know, like, so do what you feel like. I'm not saying, sir, you're a cyclist and, you know, like, but there is always an interest which is inside us, right? But if you follow that passion, I don't know, maybe tomorrow you're earning better money than a cyclist. Okay, it's good for your health. Anyways, so anybody who would like to try, I will teach you to DJ the first basic rule. That is, please sir, that is beat matching. And in beat matching, what we do is, not with music. Glenn, the beat matching. It will be only on the rhythm, as I told you. So first, nothing is easy to learn, everybody says. It takes some time. But we teach every student, no advanced tutorials, no advanced classes, just 1 month, you'll be a DJ. Okay, that's how we do basically. And today in front of me, my students are here, learn from me. All the way from Abu Dhabi, but he works in Abu Dhabi. But, you know, he did it actually 3 weeks, right? 3 weeks, right? You started playing alone. Yeah, see? So it's dedication and the interest what they put in. RPG.